and we're at Internet Citizens!
What's up people, my name is Fusion and I'm happy to be here. It's Glasgow in the building!
Woo!
No, are we in the building?
Woo!
I trust you guys because I've been travelling all over the country on this project called Internet Citizens. This is the biggest group, this is the liveliest group, we're going to have an amazing day. Throughout the whole day we'll be playing your music. It's about your adventures online, and we're just going to laugh today. If you haven't met certain people in the room, we're all going to connect with each other. We're all going to have a good time, and it's all about Internet Citizens. And it's about you guys, because you are the world leaders online. The reason why I say that is because your parents haven't got a clue what you're doing. When you go on Snapchat, when you go on, what else do you go on, Instagram, whatever platforms you're on, you guys know what you're doing. And our mission today is to connect with you, help you navigate online, and make sure whatever you want to do. Who wants to step their own YouTube channel? Put your hands up.
Edinburgh, we had like Agus, and we had like lots of Scottish names.
That's a lie.
That's a lie. That's a lie.
Don't lie, please.
Wait, so you're all consensus?
Yeah.
So you all think I didn't put my pants in under an hour?
Yeah.
Yes. No, because you said you ate haggis.
And you had to think about it.
You don't forget when you eat haggis.
Haggis is disgusting. And why would I sit here all be at a very, very serious conference?
I know.
Oh, so, it's literally like biologically impossible to like poo twice in an hour.
Yeah? Just kind of thinking about it, maybe not, yeah? And who has a friend who has their own channel online? So whatever it is, we can help you guys develop your own platforms or help your friends be successful. Yeah? Anyone here is a photographer? Cool. I love the fact, yeah, my boy Henry was saying he got the little flip out selfie thing.
Hi!
Oh, that's so cool.
Whatever it is, we're going to connect and learn to start. So who are you?
Hi, I'm Nadir. I run a YouTube channel for BENI, but I've been working with YouTube for quite a long time, in the last 2-3 years. I started my own channel about 5 months ago, and the idea behind it was to kind of provide young people who might feel like they were misrepresented online with an alternative media space, because what's great about YouTube is that no one was telling me what I can and can't say. It was really powerful, it was empowering my voice. But YouTube was providing me a space that I had to say whatever I want, whenever I wanted, and kind of like what remember for me when I was younger was when I made a video, I picked up a camera in the house, and it was a really like bad camera, by the way, so it wasn't anything fancy. And then literally within like a week, I had about 30 friends, we made a video in 24 hours, it got quite a few views, it got like 1.3, 1.4 million views in the first 24 hours. And this is a nobody in his bedroom in Wembley in London, and it just showed me that anyone can have a voice online if it resonates with people across the world. And I'm going to be around all day, we'll have a Q&A.
Cool. I've spoken to you so many times, I look far from that privilege. The Dangerdebbs, where's she at? Okay, clap her up, please.
Dude, you're the most famous person I'm interviewing ever in my life. I'm very privileged to interview you. I'm just getting good questions up. Because you're a YouTuber, how did you start?
So it kind of started, the light bulb moment I like to call it, was when I kind of explained it to you guys my first video, was 3 years ago when I was in my house, and there was a camera lying around, and they had been an attack, and a lot of people from a particular community, the Muslim community, were getting a lot of stick from mainstream media, and they were being portrayed very negatively, and I thought, oh man, I'd love to do something about that to change people's perceptions, so I had the camera in my house, sent emails to so much friends, we filmed a video, that happy video, about a week. Released it that night, woke up in the morning, had 1.4 million views, it eventually got about 3.14 million views. And it just made me realize that, wow, I can connect with people worldwide, regardless of their geographies, where they're from, or you know, whether they're from Japan or America, it didn't matter. And suddenly I had access to all these people worldwide. And it made me realize that I'd love to have a career where I was doing that all the time, and connecting with people through similar issues and similar challenges, and regardless of their religion, faith, inclination, or culture.
You connect easily with people, sounds like it.
I don't think so. I think like it's definitely something that my parents really tried to get me to do from a very young age. I really, you know when people ask me for advice, they always ask me for like technical advice, how do you make a video look like that? And I'm like, forget that, that's really not important. Technicalities of film are really not significant. It's about what happens behind the screen, right? You'll be so surprised about your relationships that you build with people behind the screen, how it affects how people behave in front of the screen. And I really like to think, anyway, I hope that, you know, I've met some of you guys, we've connected, we've had a good laugh. But really invest in social skills, like building relationships with people, making them feel comfortable around you, because good people will stick with you the rest of your life. My dad always said the best investment you can make is people. And I really feel like I'm really here today being interviewed by you because a variety of different people have helped me growing up. And they're still in my life, and I'm very fortunate enough to have people support me all the way. So invest in social skills, not technical skills first.
When you ask people, a lot of the videos you make, there's people in it, how do you like ask them to be part of your video? Because where I come from is Inverness. I asked somebody, they would totally say no. So how do you get people to be part of your video?
That is a very good question. It's very challenging. I think I'm careful about who I ask. I think I know some people who would be willing to be asked. Others I wouldn't ask because I just know they're not comfortable. But even if people were willing, it's still a challenge. So I think you have to connect with people on an idea. The A to Z video meant a lot to me because a lot of the people I know, some I didn't. But it was bringing together all over the world in one video. And the way that I connected and kind of encouraged them to be part of it was by we all had the same issue. We all had the same issue in the sense that mainstream media was telling us who we are, but we never had the opportunity to tell people who we really are. And all of them in that video felt the same. So I would recommend connecting with people through a similar challenge or a problem. Let's say you have a video and it addresses X problem. Find people who have the same problem, then they'll be so much more emotionally inclined to help you out. That's how I go around it. But also, like I said, invest in social skills. If people love you and they're emotionally invested in you, they'll help you out. I don't have the resources to provide money for people to do my videos. I don't, right? Everyone that's in my videos does it because they want to help me and support me. And that's what I mean by investing in your community around you and your social group.
When you make your videos, not just filming people, but filming yourself, how do you feel filming yourself and watching that back over and hearing your voice? It's weird.
It's definitely weird. It's probably the most daunting aspect of it all. When I started, I had friends who had been doing it for a long time, but when I did it myself, it was the most uncomfortable thing. When I first started doing it, I thought, okay, I'm going to start my own kind of YouTube channel. I know that young people really like it when there's authenticity and you're the guy filming yourself and you're talking to the camera. But then the first time I did it in public, I was like, really embarrassing because it is a really embarrassing thing. You know what British people were like, right? We're very like reserved, very proper, especially like in London. Like if you do anything out of the ordinary, people are just staring at you in the corner of their eye. So I just remember being on a train and lifting the camera up, and the whole train is like looking at you, like what is he doing? So that took a long time. To be honest with you, I'm still totally getting used to it. Like I'm not 100% comfortable filming myself in public. I'll find a quiet place somewhere, but I am getting more and more comfortable. I remember like I used to practice before I started officially. So like, I remember going to Oxford Circus, the busiest place in London. There's like a crossroad with people, hundreds of people every minute on the road. And I remember sitting in the middle and filming myself and forcing myself to talk. I wasn't recording, but I was just doing it, just to feel comfortable and getting over myself. Because that's what it is ultimately, you're getting over yourself to the point you don't care what other people think, you're just gonna do it regardless.
It's really hard, like you're just standing there and someone's watching like, why is she filming herself? You're a vlogger. They don't know what the vlogger is, just
tell
them what it is. You're part of Creators for Change. What is that all about? How does it help you?
Like a proper interview.
I've done interviews before.
It's insane. So Creators for Change is a really amazing initiative that I feel really blessed to be part of. Basically, YouTube was like, look, you know, YouTube has typical content that we all go for, and it can range from ridiculous to amazing. But YouTube really wanted to support people who were using, they felt people who were using the platform to be socially in the platform, trying to spread a good message. So they had established YouTubers who've been with YouTube since the very beginning, who have huge followings from 3 to 10 million. And it gave them an opportunity to nominate an up-and-coming channel that has potential. So I luckily was nominated by some people, and basically it was recognition of my space being used to show kids a positive light of life and people and relationships, and they've been great. It's really amazing to have a program and a company like YouTube telling you that what you're doing is great, and it just gives you a lot more confidence to kind of go on and pursue.
You've just not built relationships of you. You've not just built relationships with YouTube. You've built relationships stay here. What have you experienced at this event today? Do you think it's been great? Do you think you'll connect more with these people?
Yeah. Can't meet me one day? Absolutely. Like I said before, the moment I touched down in Glasgow. I had nothing but a positive experience. Came here and it was consistent throughout. You guys are extremely dynamic. It's had some of you in the space. You not shied away at all from anything I've asked to do. And thank you so much for that. Like, it just goes to show how much of a dynamic and eclectic group of people you are. And I'm not just saying that, but I mean it. But I mean, we were like sitting in the back and just feeling blessed that you guys performing here on stage. Like, it was incredible to see. And I have Fusion behind me, which basically means that I'm very short.
But a grim reaper.
And like, so, yeah, so.
This is my last question. Since you're from Scotland, you may not know a bit about Scotland. We don't think you actually eat haggis, we've heard. So here's some iron brew to take with you. Are you Scottish?